Are you lucky at love?
Am I lucky in love? Like at love?
Lucky at love. Do you?
I have always.
Do you attract fucking knuckleheads?
I've attracted a variety of men in my life. Some of them were men, some of them questionable. I've always been in relationships since I was 15 years old. I've always like loved having boyfriends. I've dated people since I was 15. So I've had a bunch of boyfriends, I guess. I've had experience in dating guys who were all different kinds of healthy and unhealthy for me.
Now, when you broke up with that one dude and mm-hmm. you got into stand-up, like I did the same thing. Mm-hmm. Like it was all part of a metamorphosis process. Yeah. It was all part of a, I'm going to stop doing what the fuck I'm doing and get into this. Like,
right.
I got on stage in like June. And in October, she told me she wanted to get separated.
Oh, wow.
So I walked, like, for 4 months, I walked around like, I don't want to be with this person no more. And everything sucked.
Yeah.
Like, everything just sucked. Once I got on stage, and here I am, 28, I'm out of prison, and I'm with this woman, and God bless her. She drove me to my first open mic. She forced me, like, she forced the hand, you know. But it's really tough to explain to people. Sometimes at your, like, I got into stand-up at the lowest point in my life.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got into it at a lower point in my life. And then I got all in at the lowest point in my life.
Yeah. Like,
the lower I got, the more I got into it.
Yeah.
Is that how you felt sometimes?
My first year of stand-up, I suffered like suicidal depression. Like I wasn't like, I didn't have a plan. I wouldn't actually do it, but it was in and out of my life my first year of stand-up. I got out of that relationship that I was in at 29, started stand-up. I was working for Levity at the time. And I was doing social media marketing for them. That's really like my path into comedy was like, I used to work at corporate and I ended up leaving that job because they wanted to bring someone in house. They got Rita from the improv, let me be a bartender in the lab. And they don't give those jobs to like just anyone, let alone women. And like, I'm not a career bartender. Like I'm in the back looking up, you know, basic recipes for a Manhattan. You know what I mean? Like she really believed in me. And so I was going through this breakup. She gave me an opportunity at the improv. And I was also starting my open mics and writing and getting into stand up. And it just became like I was like, this is what I'm in love with. This is what I've been missing my whole life. This is my purpose. It gave me meaning to my life in a whole new way. Oddly enough, I ended up getting into another relationship this past year. I just got out of a relationship. But he works in comedy and I just fell in love with comedy. Like that was like my main love. And then everything else was secondary. And like, he kind of saw that process of like, my first year was rough for me. Cause I was going through kind of just like everything in my life. Like, okay, now I'm in a place where I can put meaning and like finding the funny in my pain and my trauma. And also just like, you know, I think it's a crutch for me is some of these relationships. Like I've always just maybe been afraid to be fully independent, like, which I know I can be, but like who wants to be alone at night? You know what I mean? Like, and I'm not a random casual sex person. It just doesn't fulfill me. So I think that the more that I fell in love with stand-up, the like less, like my relationship began to deteriorate.
Like it was so weird to me how you think about the first 5 or 6 years of a stand-up. You know you're in love with something when you give up your apartment.
Yeah.
Like, you know you're in love with something. Like, you have to force yourself to not be home.
Yeah.
Like, I can't be home at night. Like, I don't even know what that is.
No, like, if there were nights that I would choose to, like, spend in my first years, I would have this guilty feeling like I'm cheating on my, like, my love, you know what I mean? And like, that's when I was like, okay, this is something that means so much to me. And it just like, I knew that I needed to like focus on that. And like after being in all of these relationships that just didn't work out, like thank God none of them wanted to marry me, you know, and they took it that far. Like, thank God it didn't work out, because it was a point, I'm at a point where I was like, okay, this is what I've been missing in my life. And this is what I need to feed. You know,
you
what
like
I mean?
Kids?
Kids? Yeah. Do I like kids?
Yeah, do you like kids? Do you ever see yourself having children?
Maybe one day, like when I'm older, in my 40s. Women are having kids in their 40s, so.
Yeah, my wife had it at 44.
I'd be a great pregnant 40-year-old.
But right now, comedy is
comedy. This is what I'm going to do, no matter what.
What the fuck are you giggling about?
Why did you like him? What did
he
do?
He did an error.
I knew a second ago, but now. Keep going from where you told it. Cause then
okay. You know that little forehead you got?